So is that eggnog?
Yeah.
That's noggin. I told you to get whiskey and noggin.
Wait, can I gargle that and put it back in your cup? Is that cool?
It's already been full filtered.
Are you pure Aryan?
This weird Irish German count. I have some filthy Indian in there somewhere. But.
No.
Don't
no.
we all?
Found out I had French the other day.
I'm so sorry. Oh, man.
Have you committed suicide yet?
No. Oh. That would be the French way of going out.
I thought of something way worse than have you committed suicide, but I'm not going to say it. No, I'd feel bad about it tomorrow.
I just see Corey like it's in a bathtub with a cigarette and like a
life
is shit. And he just like holds the gun to his mouth.
Pretty much. That's what happened when I found out.
Yeah.
Yeah, just put some nutmeg and raw eggs in it, and it'll be eggnog.
I prefer skim milk, egg whites,
and you would cinnamon. Like skim milk.
I make my own skim milk.
I prefer cottage cheese, you know, boiled eggs, and a little bit of paprika. Wait a minute.
Are we doing party roll recipes again?
We're doing eggnog recipes.
We should do that for the Christmas episode, party roll eggnog recipes.
I'll have to go get my... family recipe then.
I just do boiled
it's
water,
called whiskey.
Powdered milk, and some parsley on top.
Four cans of evaporated milk and whiskey.
I can't afford eggs from the store, so I just go to McDonald's and get their scrambled eggs. And then
you get a slab.
That's some hot breakfast.
Get a brick of scrambled eggs.
Oh. We were at...
Just some good nog. I got
some mayo soup there. Oh, that's a good eggnog recipe. A bunch of mayo.
That's some mayo, some
You've
sriracha.
You've got the milk and the egg already in there.
And if you're...
Dusty's wife.
Three sticks of butter.
Half a stick of butter.
We had to go to the store the next day because y'all didn't have no butter.
No, milk. Yep. It's milk, or it's mayo, some eggs, some butter, some mayo, some eggs.
Why do you need eggs? You got mayo.
Because it's eggnog, dumbass.
Sorry. Sorry, everybody.
Some whiskey.
A quart of horse jizz. A real Palomino.
We already said mayo. Yeah.
It's an emulsion.
See, I feel like Palomino would be the best because they're already a creamy color.
I feel like you've thought about this.
Oh, I just thought about it when y'all were making up your recipes.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Yeah.
And then 2 years
Perfect
ago.
Perfect suction on that asshole.
Are we funny yet?
Hey, welcome to Party Roll. I'm Dusty, and I'll be playing Butterless Trombone.
This is Corey, and I'm going to be playing Fritz Van Finkel.
I'm Vanessa, and I'll be playing Fumbles O'Shea Kinnis.
I'm Steven, and I'll be playing Jetlin Botswana.
I'm Matt, and I'm playing Carl Seven.
I'm Mark, and I'm the DM.
Yeah! Let's
Party Roll.
Let's Party Roll.
Let's Party Roll.
Into the back alley and you get jammed by a bunch of kids.
Goddamn back alley kids.
No, I think this happened to Dusty pulling his motorcycle into a back alley and getting beat up by a bunch of teenagers.
Old alley, mister.
No, he said kids, so I'm thinking like just angry 12-year-olds.
I was thinking like little cockney British pickpockets, you know?
I'm not even thinking they actually jumped him. They're probably just like, hey, you think you're cool because you have that motorcycle, don't you? Your legs are longer than the rest of your body.
Yeah. I'm not very good at motorcycles, so they kind of just pushed me over, and the weight of the motorcycle knocked me over. And I was pinned, so they could just kick me.
And he had weak ankles.
Welcome to the Party Roll! Not 50th episode. Because we didn't realize we were filming 50s episode, we did. So you guys hope you enjoyed that.
Yeah, it's gonna be good.
Yeah,
I enjoyed it.
Yeah, or not?
It'll be great.
It's gonna be an episode.
I don't know. Is it a good episode or is it a bad episode? Don't even answer it. It's all bad.
It's okay.
His grinning head shaking and nodding.
Yeah, Party roll. Great. It's okay.
Is that our official tagline? Party roll.
We think it's funny.
Party roll, because your friend said, hey, listen to this, and afterwards you were like, fuck you, dude.
We're no longer friends.
And you sat there for an hour listening while he stared at you and laughed every time.
Just looking straight into your eyes.
Yeah, man, it was funny.
So, D&D, last time on the party roll.
What did we do?
Corey has a die. I don't understand what he wants to do with it.
Okay,
do we Corey, start? Use your words.
I'm holding my die up.
I'm ready to party.
Corey, what do we say?
I'm ready to party roll.
Make sure
please.
You
please.
Got...
Okay.
May I party roll, please?
Or are you just wanting me to do my new tagline? I never forget a fat face.
Well, I've gotten used to dealing with a toddler, so I need you to make a little circle on your chest to let me know it's time to party roll.
20's up.
That is obscene, and I like it. All right.
I clockwise touched my privates.
Party roll to beat is a 12.
I got a 15. I got a 2.
Wait, I can't read.
15.
It was actually a 19. Fuck all of you.
Fuck you.
I got a 3. It was terrible.
I got a 2. You did better than me.
I got 16. Okay. Wait.
I like to get the party hopes up.
Because me
before
and Matt,
I party crush your dreams.
Me and Matt just rolled 2 15s.
Yeah.
Are you going to combine your powers together and become Captain Party?
So I agreed to take Steve to the party, and then I drove by his house, waited for him, and then when he walked out in his front yard, I just drove off. But then I hit a tree. As I was driving
and I pulled Dusty into my car to drive him to the hospital, and I got 4 flat tires, so I just went inside and played Fallout 4 for a little while. He's still in my car, which is in the middle of the street.
Shit, you guys just want to talk about Fallout for an hour?
Yes.
Welcome to the Fallout podcast, where we make Dusty feel bad because
it's the greatest game ever, and if you can't play it, you're a terrible human being.
I beat Amnesia. Remember that game from, like, 10 years ago?
It was okay.
It's like 2008.
2010.
Wow, what the fuck, man?
Sorry.
God. So, yeah, last time on the party roll. I'm going to, let's see. Who remembers the most?
I'm drinking eggnog, so no.
We had a good nap, and then Matt made out with Princess Daniela.
Wait. I did not have a good nap.
Come on, Matt. Come on.
We had a good nap.
You could do this.
They had a good nap. They had a great nap.
We had a fat nap.
And then, I did not have a good nap.
We went and then we saw a new nature fire.
That's actually pretty much.
Yeah,
what
Corey talked to a big tree.
Oh yeah. Wait. What did the tree say? Oh, it was a pun tree. Nah.
Yeah.
What does the tree say?
Oh, it was really roundabout. Like, oh, no.
Cut all this.
Yeah.
And please cut the last 55 episodes.
Yes.
So yeah, you talk to a tree.
I would like for somebody to edit that, what does the fox say, and then have Fox from Fallout 3, like, scream his rambling incoherentness.
I don't remember.
The Super Mutant Fox from Fallout 3?
That was great.
Her
rambling incoherentness.
Well, I mean, Super Mutants are no longer gendered. They lost that.
Hey, they can wear pretty flower hats.
They can.
And talk
old
about
ladies.
Their grandchildren.
I want to believe that there's a She-Hulk Super Mutant
well, no,
out there.
What was her name?
If you played the original Fallout.
Was it like Mrs. They're, Better? Mrs.
They're sterile.
So Better for me.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
I don't know what that means.
This is Corey making, making mutant creams across the land.
I usually vaguely figure out what kind of gross thing Corey's saying, but...
If only you were in my head... If only.
So yeah, you guys found another nature fire. As I feel like that's how Carl would put it.
Nature. Okay, what a nature fire? Where was that?
Another font of magic in the woods.
The tree. The tree was on fire.
No, at the very end, we found another font of magic.
Oh,
and then
the little fire.
And then
okay.
Someone who we didn't see because he came up behind us and
Fumbles?
Whispered gently said,
"Oh,
hey guys, back up! There's some kind of big spooky around there."
Oh
yeah,
yeah.
You feel some knuckles. Lightly brush across the nape of your neck.
That was Mark touching my neck. Remember, guys?
I do, but it wasn't his knuckles. It was some other bumpy appendage
he
has.
Gross.
Mark gnarled. And...
It was actually his spine that
Sorry,
was dragging out of his neck.
I turned around and rubbed my spine against your neck.
That cough reminds me. I finally listened to the Lonely Homie, and his coughing fit was hilarious.
Shout out to Lonely Homie. Your life depresses me. Yeah. So, all right.
Okay.
So, yes.
Let's party roll, guys.
To recap, right. Pretend this is a... Pretend you just
stealth.
Came back from a commercial break. Hold a stealth.
4.
You're not Seth Rogen.
Right.
You hit the dirt. You just flop down on the ground. A little gnome.
17 to stealth.
Okay.
Stealth, Mark. How many 17s do I have?
Let me recap first before you all start trying to hide from the person who's standing 2 feet behind you.
I pick up Fritz and set him back up.
I think one hand on the top of the head, kind of.
You came upon. Oh, I'm going to try and like steal Spencer.
Harmontown's
shtick now. Go for it. You came upon. No, I can't do it. He's too good. You came upon a large clearing with a glowing ball of green fire in the middle. No font around it, just kind of floating there over the grass.
Trashy one over here.
As you, just as one of you started to step foot in the clearing, you heard the voice behind you say, careful. The Guardian's been active of late.
Oh, shit.
So, yeah. I pivot my head around 180 degrees and look at that person.
So was this before or after he was like massaging our necks with his gnarled knuckles?
That was what we in the biz call a joke.
Oh, okay. I thought that was just what we in the biz call a creepy back massage.
So what do I see? Do I have to roll for it?
No, he's standing right there.
Who is it?
He hides.
he dives into the woods.
Don't go over there.
You see standing in front of you a...
All you can hear is the...
What appears to be a tall, dark-haired elven man.
Oh.
And some kind of... clad in some kind of leather armor and light cloak.
Oh, describe him.
Is it studded leather? Please say it is. Oh, God.
Studded.
Oh, God. Okay, maximum boner.
What a stud.
Get out.
No.
Jenwin has to move his spell book over his crotch.
I already have my algebra book.
Jenwin, can you come up front and solve this problem?
Okay, do you guys
take the chalk, Steven?
Do you guys do anything other than gawking at this beautiful elf man?
I rolled a stealth.
Boy.
Okay. Roll again.
Six. I did better.
All right, you hit the dirt a little harder this time.
I pick him right back up. I say, you keep falling.
I love it.
I'm going to roll to intimidate.
Child must learn to stand.
I got 17 to intimidate him.
What are you doing?
Nice. I'm going to intimidate him.
Like, you gotta role play it.
Play some green sleeves.
Hey!
Scary one.
Fella, you don't walk around here with your hair and your shoes on.
I feel like Fumble sets a natural minus 20 to intimidate.
He has a plus one.
Have you seen him fumble things around?
There's a lot of stuff caked in that fur. It's pretty intimidating. So
have to sidebar here and give a shout out to all the amazing fan art we've received lately.
Yeah, seriously.
Oh, yeah.
Some of Fumbles.
Oh, yeah.
And I did declare, so I'm now going to have to say it on the podcast to make it official. Since there's been fan art, Paul Blart is real.
Yay! Let's Blarty roll.
God damn it.
Yeah. Well, let's make this whole episode about Paul Blart. So Corey gets mad again.
Wait, can this guy who's here, can he be Paul Blart?
Can he be on a Segway?
Can he be Paul? Can he be Segway Blart guy?
Can he at least be a mall cop?
Why don't you ask him?
Look what you did.
Hey, are you a mall cop? Because if so, I respect you. Otherwise, I don't want to hear what you got to say. Otherwise, that's Fumbles.
Why are you riding that? Other people aren't allowed to ride those. Only mall cops.
Well, that was Fumbles talking to him. That was his attempt at intimidating. Look, I'm not going to have any respect for you, fella.
He's scared because that made no sense to him whatsoever.
Unless you protect your local mall.
He looks down at Fumbles perplexed. It's like, never have I seen a satyr in the forest, much less with such interesting mannerisms.
I think he likes you.
Who are you, friend?
You sound like that.
Because
he got sat on
me. You're just going to sound like that for the next day.
Yeah, no, that's everything.
Shadowin got really sick.
He's getting sick and everything.
Yeah, he's still coughing up the black goo that I keep.
Also, I am also coughing up black goo, so.
Which I also keep putting in vials.
Yeah.
Well, friends, first, I'd say I
donate
can ask that
to
of
Patreon
you,
for your own vial of Stephen Flynn.
Gross. What brings you to the forest?
I guess we're here to barter with you. You sound like a salesman.
I'm trying to find his voice.
That's okay. We're looking for the Descendant's Grove.
I'd say you found yourself neck deep. At least
neck deep.
You must have hit that a good 2 kilometers back, or whatever system of measurement we happen to use.
Neck deep.
I looked at Fritz for a second.
At least 30 cows back.
Is this grove groovy?
Do you say
I was told
to
it would be.
I rolled a stone.
Well, we're looking for the leftover descendants then.
I love how you're the one speaking for everybody. And you can't even tell.
Now
you sound like a creepy old homeless man.
I love it. Great.
Now, why exactly would someone be looking for them?
King told us to.
King Dilanthus kind of doesn't like them.
The king done told us to come talk to these guys.
Cheery as ever.
We are on top secret mission that we're telling you about.
We went and saw him, I think it was yesterday, and I'd given him a Paul Blart standee, but I didn't see it in his throne room when we came back, so I'm kind of worried he's regifted it.
See what you did. See what you did.
I did.
Wow. Might as well tell everyone Walkmans are real, too.
They already are.
There actually was fan art of that, I believe.
So that's real.
Thank you, fan art people.
Everything
for
dumb is real. Hell, just yeah. Every dumb thing that our players make up is real.
It's you magic. Heard it. You heard it right here, folks.
It's magic.
So from the fan art, was my magic. Blazing Nug staff real too?
Hell yeah. Jedwin's mullet is real.
Damn it, I've lost his voice again.
Jedwin's mullet distracted. Was
I will what, ask. Are your, what are your intentions when you find these descendants of yours?
Well, I reckon we're going to want to jaw with him for a bit, at least.
This term, I apologize, I've been around for quite a while, but I don't think I've heard it before.
You know, sit
it
down.
It makes me want to talk to him.
Have a chat, jaw. I never heard that.
What do really? You use your jaw for?
Chew the fat with him. You know how it is.
I'm looking more and more confused as Jedwin keeps talking. I'm in the back and I just very quietly like take my jaw off a little bit and I put it back on.
You just hand it to somebody. Just
imagine you putting it back on upside down.
You try
second.
To hand it to me and I push it back to you like, no, no, oh, dude, get no.
Keep it on.
Sorry.
Well, I don't imagine you'd be surprised by this, but they... I don't think they really like visitors.
That is shocking.
Not very nice.
And, well, it seems very odd to me that all of you seem to have found your way straight here to the magic center of the forest. Are there magical ones amongst you?
We had a map.
Yes.
Right. A map.
See, yeah. I got this no. map here, and I drew on, there's like, that's where the dirt bears.
I guess we do, in fact, have a map.
There's the remember, groovy grove where we're supposed to be.
I had the map for a while, because I took it away from
can
the
Can I
fumbles.
Aside that I love the idea that anybody who asks you guys questions, you just spill everything that has happened so far. Like, oh yeah!
I'm an honest man.
King didn't tell us what to be not discreet and whatnot.
Also, I don't know if I trust that king no more. I want to know what the fuck's going
That's
on
true.
With anybody else.
I really have a feeling we're going to have to kill that guy eventually.
This person's name is Raimi.
But he's my best friend.
That's true.
What's this person's name?
Raimi.
Raimi.
What?
Yes.
This guy?
Raimi Creamstaff.
Unfortunately not.
Okay.
You haven't asked him his name yet. Well, you did, but he
unfortunately not is a really weird
unfortunately
name.
Unfortunately not.
What's your name, friend?
Well, I suppose you've spilled everything to me, other
yeah,
than
I
spilled my chocolate milk on the way.
Other than who you are,
I'm assuming you must be at least somewhat tangentially related to the descendants, and we're trying to just get to talk to them.
Well, you could say I'm familiar with them. I have been in this forest for many a year.
Tom Bombadillo.
The more we talk,
but now I go to watch my wife wash in the rain. It's hot.
neck deep in the woods.
That's all I remember from reading when I was 12.
Oh,
I was
yeah.
just like, yeah.
They fucking boned
yeah,
all the
she's
time.
She's going to go wash in the rain.
Mom, get out!
Mom, I'm reading Felsh.
She's washing in the rain!
But the king done told us his story, and the more he talked, the more not nice he seemed, and we're just trying to get the whole picture painted to see what the painted picture is.
Well, I believe I've been rude. Let me introduce myself.
We want to paint Jaws.
You have been quite rude, actually. I've asked you your name twice.
Wooed.
He extends his palm in what you...
High five?
One of you. Or, I guess Jedwin, I guess, would be the one most knowledgeable to know.
And talk to the hand because the face
elven
ain't listening
greeting,
fashion.
Just kind of a... I don't know. Whatever
I was raised by a human.
It's the face off.
Yeah, does he go to the white face?
Goes,
hand on his
he
face?
Goes to stroke his hand across your face in the classic elven fashion.
Stroke.
Strong man, stroke
kind of
man. Jedwin doesn't even know Elvish.
Kind of lightly bows. You may call me Dravik.
Is he Russian now?
No, that's just his name. That's how you pronounce it.
Is he from Transylvania?
Raimi, got it.
My name is Dravik.
Wait a minute. Dravik, ain't you Erdrin's dad?
His face goes a little dour.
What happened to your face? It's all dour. Ew.
Yeah, gross. It looks like sour cream. Get it out of here.
You know my son?
Yeah, he's been helping us along our way. We were talking to him not just but a day or two ago.
Me and him are best friends. See, look at our photo collection of our fun adventures together.
That's a pretty good photo.
This is when we went swimming. This was when he was my robot oar. That was his favorite. This was when we turned baseball. He was bat this time.
Oh, he always was my special little guy.
He's pretty special, all right. You've raised him well.
That
I don't think he was ever around.
That makes you all an interesting bunch indeed.
Wait a minute.
I don't know if you've been listening to us or not, but we was already an interesting bunch.
If Erdrin's your kid and you're part of the Dissectants, then what would that make Erdrin?
Why? Some call him a half-elf.
Oh, bastard, I knew
it. No, because like, he works at the king's house and you guys come over here. So, is he like working with you guys and he's against the king?
Is he a disinfectant?
Is he an antimicrobial?
Oh my gosh.
I have not spoken with my son in at least, forgive me, it's hard to keep track of years, but at least a human lifetime.
Yeah, I have daddy issues too.
My mom kicked me out of my house.
Half-elves don't live that long.
Would you like us to send him a message?
200 years, don't they?
I don't think. Well, whatever. Yeah, yeah. It's whatever.
Let's call it. We're calling them Numenoreans. They live 200 years. Elves live, I think, about like 800 or something in this.
Yeah, they're not immortal like Tolkien.
Well, I'm going through all my lores here. In Elder Scrolls, elves live about 2,000 years if they're healthy. Anyway. Please correct me on my Forgotten Realms lore, if you know it. Tell me all about Dristopgarden.
Gnomes live a pretty long life.
Do they?
Yeah, they're like, adulthood starts at like 120 something, I think.
Nice.
Yeah.
It's a lot of time to fuck up and nobody blame you for it.
Yeah, true. Yeah, pretty much.
You want to kill some people, you got a whole 100 years not to end up in the...
You just go to juvie.
Penitentiary.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Is there a message you'd like for us to bring your son?
Tell him,
I'll be home for Christmas, and then give a wink so he knows the truth.
Kill him, Doug. Keep working on that bow arm.
Okay.
It's only been 1,000 years.
Oh, shit, I forgot what he told us to
tell him. Yeah, I mean, he was a okay shot, but he definitely could work on it.
He was not very good.
Really, nobody there was.
Anyways, outside of the fact that we do, in fact, know your son, and we were sent from the king, we've been very open with you about all this information. Because, like I said, we're trying to get both sides of the story here.
Well, I was sent here many a year ago to find the descendants myself, and, well, this is where I've been ever since.
So they're not here, then?
Are you lost?
Are property taxes low out here?
I know where I am, I assure you of that.
Because you're neck deep in the forest, apparently, and I'm just curious.
So that, huh?
We're way past the tip, then.
Our little turtlenecks.
I'm still curious as to how you
neck deep
seem to have made a beeline for the Font of Magic.
That is very strange.
Oh, who is directing us here? I had the stick of... True direction,
yeah,
we had a
magic stick.
We got a stick.
Stick. Believe the story.
We bought it from a very reputable wizard that Jedwin destroyed his mind.
I'm persuade him that we used the stick of truth.
Oh, go, please. Please do so.
Stick of true direction.
That's going to be a nat 20, which makes
Holy
it
shit.
a 27.
Please, Damn. Please talk this sentence out.
Well, what happened was we knew where the forest was because the king done gave us the map, and then he gave us a map that went a little bit farther in. but then we was lost. But luckily, our friend Fumbles here.
Hello.
He got a magic stick of true direction, and he's been throwing that. We've just been following him all the way here.
He looks at you perplexedly for a good 6 seconds.
Jedwin just gives him a hands out, going, huh?
And, kind of shakes his head, and that actually might be the dumbest story I've ever heard, but
you're dumb.
Why would anybody make that up?
I don't know.
It's totally boring her.
Well, I mean, how else are we going to get out of here? Look at us.
Well,
I'm some kind of half-elf swamp thing.
That's not a dumb story. It's a real story.
I thought we were following.
I like the idea of Barilla suddenly getting all hurt about it. He's like, it's a real story.
It's real. It's what really happened.
It's what happened.
Come at you guys. It's not okay.
Why don't you believe us? You're a son, my best friend.
See my photo albums?
Look at photos. You know it's true.
He trusts so good.
Well,
look
regardless.
Look at our album, trust exercise.
As I mentioned probably too long ago, this is not the safest area in the forest to be. Actually, only over the last few days, the Guardian has been stirring quite regularly. The forest feels slightly wrong.
Funny story. We done killed a guardian over at the lake one.
He started it.
He totally started it.
His eyes flare a little bit. That's not a good thing.
Well,
he tried to eat us with water snakes.
We had no choice, and Aiden started it. Like, he started fighting him, so.
He always was a hot tempered lad.
He was working on his bow arm.
He shot arrows at it like it wasn't made of water.
He was really showing off. It was kind of annoying.
Not all his right. best friend moment.
He's pretty obnoxious sometimes. That rascal.
We didn't take pictures of that.
This is the picture of my disappointment.
All right, well, I'll tell you, I have a place not far from here. So, if you'll be so kind as to follow me,
okay,
I will try and show you a bit of hospitality.
Okay.
You don't piss on hospitality.
My little slice of forest.
Hospital what?
You guys kind of had, well, I'd say off the beaten path, but you haven't been on a path for a while. You were guided by a gentle breeze blown by Grandfather Tree to the Font of Magic. So you're just
okay.
And Fumble Stick.
Sidebar here. Why aren't we telling him how the hell we got here?
He keeps asking if there's a magic person around.
Oh.
And I don't like people asking about my shit like
that's
that.
That's understandable. I understand. I got it.
That's a little weird. I don't trust that.
You head on through the forest. It's kind of rough going. You're going, you know, there's trees and roots. And
are we to about the shoulders now?
Well, you were neck deep before. So you're only going to get deeper.
All right.
Well, actually, I'd say the font is probably sort of the midpoint of the forest. So, yeah, you're about back down to shoulders, I guess.
All right.
Thanks,
Steven.
You're nipple deep now.
Let me know when we're like ass to elbows area.
Ass to bows.
As everyone know, that's our classic sleeping method here at the party roll. Once
ass
we all finish
elbow.
For the night, yeah. We just get on the ground, ass to elbows. And
ass to elbow, balls to mouth, all the way around in a circle.
In this communal house we all live in.
Yes.
The compound.
Yeah, it's my the compound.
Here at the Party
yeah.
Roll compound.
Yeah.
Join us on Patreon and get your own white Party Roll robes.
come join the Matt compound. He's our Lord and Savior.
Quick, everyone, suck Matt off in the closet. Wait, everyone else doesn't do that too? Not just me?
Someone's getting all special right. treatment around here.
La-dee-da.
When are you going to impregnate me, by the way, with the next...
Hey, you get Matt bucks. You can redeem them.
Matt says he'll get my mouth pregnant. Does that work, you
this
guys?
This is a really weird cult.
Gonna get you mouth pregnant.
It's based around money, but not real money, Matt money.
Matt bucks.
Matt,
would Mia be okay with us posting that?
Probably.
That's amazing.
Well, let's do it without awesome. Asking her.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Would you? Yeah. Would you be okay with your likeness?
Oh yeah, that's fine.
On the internet. He didn't even let me finish that.
I swear.
And they're gonna walk up. Hey, I recognize you from that drawing, dude.
One day when I just don't give a shit, that will be my back tat.
Perfect.
Oh, I it will wait. Be. One day.
Just, listeners,
just Matt's balls we have amongst us
a graven image of Matt, the also known as the studio head of MGDM Studios.
And our Lord and Savior at the Matt Complex.
And the one who makes Dusty mouth pregnant twice a week.
That's right. He says my tonsils have little wombs inside.
It's a gift.
It's a gift.
It is a picture of him. Pull that up again. Let me describe it in excruciating detail. See a picture of him sitting in front of the...
I like how you're kind of snarling.
Sitting in front of the removed head of Mayor McCheese. Around him is a halo, if you will, of delicious golden McDonald's French fries.
Dancing around.
With the gleaming arches above his brow.
What does it say, El Señor Big Mac?
Yes, it does.
Well, you know, in Mexico, it's just...
Mr. Big Mac.
I was trying to make like a Pulp Fiction reference, and it just got stupid.
I think our audience is a little too young to know what Pulp Fiction is.
Let's call that out.
Pretty
again.
Underground, you know.
If you don't agree with that statement, please tell us.
Anyway, so you guys are climbing ass to elbows through the forest.
down to the nape.
Although we were like 10 when Pulp Fiction came out.
Yeah, I mean...
Knees to eyeballs.
Still watched it, though.
Yeah.
My dad did not care.
You know, Aliens. You guys weren't around for that movie that came out before.
I watched Pink Floyd's The Wall when I was in elementary school with my dad.
Actually, your dad told me he did not like Pink Floyd's The Wall.
That had boobies.
But we watched it.
That's true. He said he didn't like it because of the cartoons, and then I got sick.
Oh. That's the part I liked. The big ball sack judge.
He told me that was I actually... He just know liked, Corey's dad.
He just liked the
his reasons.
He just liked the part where the kid sat on nails. Oh wait, that's Tommy. Never mind.
We all hang out with Corey's dad. Not Uncle Neil though.
Yeah, don't hang out.
Fucking Uncle Neil.
I had one girlfriend who,
because Uncle Neil likes to fiddle about. Just kidding. That was a Tommy reference.
What did Matt's girlfriend like to do?
One could say he was almost a pinball wizard.
Whoa. I want to hear about Matt's
Okay,
ex.
My girlfriend. Her current dad? No.
Do you have a picture?
Long time ago. Sure, yeah.
Will you describe her in excruciating detail?
A long time ago.
Mr. Hamburglar Mayor underneath her.
He let us, like, he told us to watch Shaun of the Dead, and so we watched Shaun of the Dead, which has like a million fucks in it. But then he got mad at me when I put a Tenacious D song on a mix CD.
Oh, yeah, you guys were all churchy.
Yeah, we were all churchy.
Whoa, wait, what?
Yeah. Huh. Shaun of the Dead, but didn't like Tenacious D.
And was her uncle?
Is this young, very young Matt's girlfriend?
Yeah.
Okay.
But this was her uncle, though?
No, her dad.
Oh, okay.
Uncle Neil. Yeah, it was her Uncle Neil.
When did Shaun of the Dead come out? 2007?
Wait.
2004.
Your ex-girlfriend's dad was Corey's Uncle Neil?
Yeah.
What? Holy shit.
You know, don't say that because of how Dusty works. That's going to happen now.
Yeah,
you're going to realize that it actually is Corey's Uncle Neil.
That would be so badass.
Hey, what is she up to?
Yeah, what's Corey's cousin up to?
What?
Yeah, single mom.
Huh. Dude, congrats, you're an uncle.
Again.
Nice.
Hey, let's continue with the role playing.
Wait,
sorry,
how old is... No, okay, let's just
technically, we're role playing with Corey's family right now, actually.
Oh, and Matt's family.
That's true.
Probably. Okay.
Well, it's Corey's family. Matt's just coming all over it. So.
Yay!
What?
No, I'm not feeding into this one.
Yeah, we're going to skip that
one. If they join the cult, then, I mean, it's going to happen.
I was going to say.
Right. Well, technically, we're all family within the rat complex.
You guys are climbing through the forest, and eventually, after a good, I'd say a good 40 minutes or so, just huffing it. Hoofing it. Not huffing it.
We're huffing it. Huffing
the forest.
Hey, I gave that up.
Hoofing through the forest, you know,
huffing gas.
It's tough going over roots and hills and dells.
Adels? It's tough going over Adels.
There's so many Adels.
You finally get to what looks to be a little ramshackle hut.
Gross.
And looks like it's been there for a while.
Who shackled that ram up to that hut?
I'm going to read a book on basic English and just never use any interesting words.
Good, you should.
Yeah.
Never use those.
Start to use a word and go, God, I can use that. Okay.
I can use it against me.
It's an ugly old square thing that people live in.
Then the response would be, yeah, something.
You're
else.
An ugly old square thing that people live in.
Your brother's an old square thing. Corey thought that was
Corey likes
See, there's
it.
No escape.
Nope.
Sorry, sorry, continue.
So yeah, a little shack. It's just about big enough for all of you guys to fit in.
Cool. Is it like a love shack?
Damn it, I was thinking that. I don't remember.
Did you guys leave your steeds at the entrance of the forest?
I've actually been on Cupcake the whole time because I was very
I really
hurt.
Don't think they can make good going through the forest.
They're fine.
Cupcake
they
can
it.
Do whatever the hell she wants.
A dog? Straight.
A dog, probably.
Yeah, the cart. Totally
yeah. A robo fucking horse?
I definitely not a horse with a cart.
No, the robo horse had lasers and razor beams attached. So
it cut the horse down the entire way.
I want some razor beams.
Razor beams. This is so refreshing in this forest.
Razor beams.
There are razor blades with laser beams attached.
Okay, so the horse turns into the ridiculous tree-cutting machine from the fourth Indiana Jones movie.
I like to think Ferngully.
Yeah. Oh, so just they just cut trees down for the sake of evil.
Yeah.
Because put the X on it.
Destroying company. makes money just to destroy the rainforest.
How do you guys make money? Right. Pollution!
And I'm a cool jazzy ooze ball. Hey. I like to sing jazz and I'm made of oil.
You need to make that a little more Tim Curry, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
That's Tim Curry?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's Tim Curry.
I didn't know that.
Absolutely.
Someone needs to catch up on their Ferngully knowledge.
I'm their Tim Curry knowledge.
Yeah, step outside the compound sometimes and watch a movie.
They don't allow movies in the Matt Pound.
I mean, you will get punished most dutifully if you do watch outside media.
I will say, if you want to get some good Tim Curry in you, go watch Congo.
Oh, absolutely.
Best movie ever.
Perfect accent.
So I'm sorry, I'm Fern guilty.
Like gorillas.
That's the gorilla with
Michelle Simon. Amy. Pretty gorilla.
Amy, pretty gorilla. Tickle Amy.
Amy doesn't
Bad
like
gorilla.
Gorilla.
Go away.
Go away, gorilla.
Stop tickling.
Amy, just smash him with your gorilla strength, you idiot. I wish you were a chimpanzee and you'd eat their faces.
Amy, snoo-snoo. This episode is called Sidebar.
Sorry. Welcome to the Sidebar. We have drinks.
I like to think in the Matt Complex, all we can watch is Matt sex tapes, but it's half of them are just him masturbating.
You're obsessed with this.
What? You get one of his favorite fetish has become infinite recursion tapes. So it's pictures of him touching himself to tapes of him touching himself.
Dude, that and then would there's be just amazing. A mirror. You were not there when we went out, and we actually had like a half hour conversation about Matt having a complex. Yeah, we actually were going to go get a big complex together and let Matt be the leader.
That was when we went to that shitty restaurant where the food was terrible and the service was terrible.
No, I was there. I was going to be part
I
of
had
the complex.
Diarrhea. I had
diarrhea. Corey was so there. Was he there? I don't think he was.
Well, I know we've talked about living in a
Corey, hey man, we do a lot of stuff with you.
I'm pretty sure Corey wasn't there.
I feel like we've talked about the complex a few times.
Corey wanted to be there.
If you're talking about that one place, there was a one time we went to a restaurant and I kept having diarrhea.
No,
in the
you
bathroom.
Weren't there because then you said you wanted to go to that restaurant and then you went and it was shitty, even though I told you so. And you should have listened.
Oh yeah.
Wait,
yeah. On the downtown area place.
You could say the square. There are a lot of
I wasn't there.
And also, most of our
later.
Fans have figured out where we live.
Yeah, okay. Should we play D&D? Because we're getting like really, we're sidebarring off the sidebar right now.
we're just losing.
We're now at the
so
quarter bar.
Listeners. That's really bad.
Let's get back to that Nape. That ramshack Nape.
So, D&D.
So, yeah, he kind of beckons you guys into a shack in the woods. This sounds great. Like,
I find a shack in the wood, I'm going in there. Yeah. Trust me, there's always something good inside.
Is Danielle still with us?
She is. Okay, she's kind of quietly tagging along.
Sure.
Which now he rings it up. Now this woman here, she doesn't much look like an adventurer, hired sword.
Hey, that's not very nice, fella.
She could be. She's not, but she could be.
Well, she's a lady in nice clothing with a shawl wrapped around her. That's not usually
how
adventurers carry themselves.
Are you saying my basketball shorts are not nice?
You made Mark have a drunken hiccup.
The basketball shorts have not been drawn, so they are not canon yet.
Yeah. I did draw them. It was on an old drawing.
Far, everybody draws you naked.
I like it.
True. I think people think he has like regular sailor
legs. And Fumble's giant little Donnie dong that's just huge as dong, but he's not aware of his giant dong.
He has like regular people legs.
I don't think anybody drew that, Dusty.
No. That's what the fan said. And then.
No, Dusty, I think you made that up in your head.
No. Someone,
I think you've been thinking about Fumble's dong.
No, someone told. Oh, I can pull it up. Someone said,
please.
I think Fumble.
Okay, pull it up between episodes.
Yeah, okay.
We pull it out between episodes.
God damn it.
It's Danielle K.
Yes. It's Daniel Tare too, one of the two.
Okay. No, I'm telling Erdrin's father.
Okay.
It's Danielle K.
No, it's not. Danielle K said something else.
He looks as if that doesn't mean
I know Danielle K, okay, and that's something that he wouldn't say.
Why are you traveling with a civilian?
We're talking
about
the fan. We're talking about the character.
Oh, never mind.
You ask a lot of questions for not giving many answers.
I'm a curious man.
I'm a curious man.
Gonna high five him.
You hold your hand up to him, and he just kind of looks at it.
I put my hand on his shoulder, and I squeeze a little bit.
Thank you.
Smell that.
I say, so what are we doing here?
Well, first I wanted to get us a little further away from the center of the forest. As I said, there's been quite a bit of stirring, and ever since the previous guardian was killed, I think the rest of them are starting to lose their dormancy.
Should we kill this guardian too?
Please don't.
Oh, okay.
We totally could if you need us to.
Yeah, we'll do it.
I mean, this dude over here, like, fucking mincemeat that last one. I mean, he's, like, all over that lake. It's disgusting.
Oh, actually, it was DM on a roll, Professor Nerd MD.
That's too many names. That guy. Oh, yeah, that guy.
Yeah. The guy, the guy that called out Mark.
No.
Okay, sorry. Anyway.
So, hospitality. Now, what does that mean?
You ever... I'm not going to explain that.
Okay. I mean, I knew what it meant. That was just...
He prepares a... he offers you a little bit of what he has, which is some kind of... A little bit of dry bread.
Gross.
Some kind of lukewarm tea.
I take it and then throw the bread on the ground because it's gross.
I don't have to eat it, but I do. And I eat the stuff on the ground, too. Just because I'm being very polite.
I crumble my bread up in my tea and mush it up and then scoop it out with my hand. And eat it.
Rub me some swamp tea.
Tea bread.
Smart.
Yeah, that's man, smart, that's actually. All you got. You gotta eat it.
All those days in the swamp where we used to eat tea bread.
We ain't even ever had bread until I got to the city.
You just had crusts.
Well, not even. Well, no.
How do you get crusts without bread?
That's all they had.
It would push
in the oven, and it just came out.
We only knew how to make crusts.
Just crumpled up bits of crust for some reason.
You put a full thing of dough in there, and you pull it out.
Just crust,
swamp crust,
burnt crust.
But there's obviously a center that someone like dug out.
No, I mean, we tried to make bread one time, but I don't want to talk about.
Why are you looking for magical creatures or such that you were talking about earlier?
The thing that you mentioned.
Well, I keep forgetting his voice as I drink more liquor. It's so weird.
Your salesman voice.
Yeah. No, my salesman voice. I'll pull that out later.
Well, adventurers.
Well, adventurers.
That was...
You can't handle my potions.
God. Sorry, what did you ask him?
Dungeon.
Oh, magical.
Dungeon master.
Well, the descendants are not all that keen on the magic arts, at least in a traditional sense.
Mm-hmm.
They're never big on it when this used to be their island, and they're certainly not big on it now, ever since the... Grandfather, Tenlanthus, or King, current king, I assume's grandfather. I've kept some small tabs on what's going on in the main city. But,
if you keep too many open, it will mess with your computer's memory.
Damn it. Keep going.
I was going to say, you should make them bigger.
Grandpa,
you can see
that's
him.
Why nothing alone. You have to close out the tab.
But I assume little Nomarius has ascended to the throne now to become Tenlanthus III. But they're... Well, when they came with great magical power and kind of just crushed
from
any
the sun?
Resistance.
Yeah, can you clarify that for us? We asked
he
him.
He does like to say that.
Because he said that they came from the sun, and then I was like, you mean like hypothetically? And then he gave me like a really weird look.
He just kept saying the same thing.
The religion they established does indeed say they're from the sun. Truth be told, I don't know where they're from.
They're actually from Iowa.
I was, like, confused because the sun's, like, billions of miles away, and it's just a big ball of burning gas. Like, I don't even understand how
I feel like you shouldn't know that.
I shouldn't know that.
He went to swamp school.
And then I cough actually, up more black goo.
Actually, a little bit of lore lesson on something I do know. The sun and moon in... God, what's the name of this planet?
Dungeons and Dragons.
I forgot.
Nerd.
That's Elder Scrolls. It's not Faerun. Faerun is the continent. I forgot the name of the planet they're on.
Tamriel.
But that's the name of the
planet
continent.
Version 2.0.
Asriel? The sun and moon are actually portals to different planes. So the sun is just a giant portal to the plane of elemental fires. And I'm going to just throw maple nuts at Dusty to make him quiet. Hopefully he will crunch those into his mic and make less noise. There we go.
So crisp.
So yes, that's what the sun and moon actually, or at least the sun. I think the moon actually is a heavenly body. But the sun is, yeah, just a portal to the plate of Illinois fire.
Vardenfell.
Illinois fire.
Vardenfell. Yes. I was going to start saying Fallout things, but those are just real places in the current U.S. It's Boston.
A magical place, Boston. I wish we could all go there. Boston.
You guys, a bunch of fucking fairies and gnomes and shit.
You think you're wicked smart with all your magic?
Dude, do they have that voice in
there?
Fall
aren't
four?
Enough people. There's a few, but there's only a few people
God
really with good Boston
it
accents.
Yeah,
the
accents,
game.
Like,
it has,
basically
it has been like 200 years. Yeah. So.
I don't care. It should have gotten worse.
Well,
that
accent's
time
fucking eternal.
I agree. That should have gotten worse.
Whatever. Okay, just. That's true. I'm going to kill just the sidebar after this because we keep going off on them, but I just have to ask, like, how are there foreign people in Fallout games? Like, there are people with, like, British accents and Russian accents.
This is America, Mark.
Foreign people. Although it is supposed to be, like, in 1950s America.
Well, so do you think maybe they were just, like, their family was isolated for
probably
the 200 years? And
you're right. Like
so they just kept that accent?
Like, Ukrainian hotel owners?
Yeah.
Dear Todd Howard, please write us back and
please explain
your shitty lore.
There are people with accents.
Why are you ruining
America?
Mark's Aryan utopia?
200 years later. Why would
200
they still have
years
accents
later when they're like, they're the only person that sounds like
well,
that?
Well, I guess this is. Never mind. There's spoilers involved. But there are vehicles for traveling places.
Yeah, guys. Isn't Fallout 4 great for people who can play it?
It really is, dude. You should play it.
Okay, I killed the sidebar. Okay.
Dusty just died.
He just killed himself. That was really sad. We're going to continue on, though. Anyway, yeah. So he's explaining. Let me try and figure this out by human reckoning. Roughly 70 years ago?
Yes.
The... Cholanthus the First came to this island with his armies, and I did count myself amongst them. But he hired me just on the mainland. He had already established himself at that point, and he had a very particular goal in mind, which he didn't quite tell us, but he did offer quite the riches and...
What was that goal?
He didn't tell us.
Oh.
So basically, you were just a mercenary much like ourselves.
One could say that.
Would you like to join our mercenary group?
I'll be
we
your
could
best
use
friend
the wise older person. We don't have one of
you're
those.
You're really old.
I feel like you're typecasting me.
Well, old you man, are an elf. Would you like to come with us?
I mean, you don't look it, but you are an elf, so you're probably older.
You can sleep in my bed with me.
Damn elves.
Bumbles.
It also looks like you're living out of an old shack, so you might be better off with us.
We got the goat thing, little boy.
We have bear pelts.
Call me a little boy.
The scary man.
I'm 130, asshole.
Mr. Little Boy.
Well, as I said, I've been in these woods for...
That's Professor Little Boy to you.
Professor Little Boy. And I suppose at this point, I think we've spoken enough, introduced ourselves, though I definitely still have questions. But I think I owe it to you. Let's go see the Descendants.
Okay, cool.
Let's do it.
I'm so nervous. Am I dressed right?
No, please.
I've eaten my bread mash that I made.
Fumbles, I give you my cummerbund.
We're going to... How far is it going to be to get to the Descendants?
It's going through the forest. It's going to be somewhat slow, but I know some shortcuts as long as you can keep up.
Can Cupcake come, or do you mind if I tie her up in near a good chewing spot?
A chewing spot?
What does she chew?
Also, help me wear
whatever's around. Grass, leaves.
Actual chew.
You can...
Yeah.
She likes... I was going to say that.
I like to... I like to throw a little skull on the ground around where she chews. Really peps her up. God. She likes menthol.
Every now and then you just hear behind you...
That's a... Bing! I don't know where she gets a pop from. I didn't bring that at all.
She won't empty that shit out, though. She puts it back on her saddle.
She says it has original patina.
He says you can tie her up here at the shack. She should be fairly safe. Holiday, these woods, they have been a little darker of late, but
what do you mean a little darker?
It should be fine.
Oh,
no, it'll be all right. I'll
find a way. Okay.
It sure sounds like he's not saying it won't be all right.
Well, if I come back and my mule is dead, I'm gonna have to go buy another one.
That'll be 10 gold on your head,
and no one can replace. And you'll have to.
Well, I mean,
or is that 5 gold?
Cheap. No, it was 8 gold.
8 gold.
I mean, someone that breeds mules could easily replace her. She's just an animal.
Wow.
Oh, jeez, dude.
Damn. I hold Ambrosius's ears.
I was raised in the swamp.
Do you hold them until she whimpers because it hurts?
No. And when somebody came along and at the mirror, we just had to go breed us up a new one.
It was my dad's turn that time. That poor foal.
I say, okay, let's go. And I hold up my hand to high five Airdrin's dad again.
He walks past you.
I slap him in the back.
Slap his ass.
Slap his ass.
Yeah.
Do a little slap ass.
Classic.
Up high, slap down ass. Low. Too slow.
Ha. Ha. Initiated.
See, now we're all drunk.
Initiate okay. Laughter so, protocol.
So we're heading towards the Descendant's Grove. Do we see anything of interest? I do a perception check.
So Pap
you
is
go
with
there.
Us?
Nat 20 plus 20.
I got an 8 to perception checking.
Everybody else want to perceptify?
I rolled a hide.
80 perceptions.
Nat 20 to hide.
Fuck yeah, bitches.
Why are you Seth Rogen again?
I don't know.
We're converting.
He's been drinking a lot of eggnog.
20 for perception?
I just put like half a cup of whiskey in it.
Okay. You hear a...
do I hide?
Where are you hiding?
Where is there to hide? What's around me?
On Carl.
You're walking through the forest.
I hide behind Carl.
You hide behind his leg like a little shy toddler.
I like attach myself to his back.
I put him on my shoulders.
And you hold him up high aloft to where he is clearly hidden.
Lift him up into the loft of that shack.
Anyway, what did I perceptify?
All right. You hear a bit of stirring in the bushes kind of to your right.
Someone's making tea.
Dravik holds his hand up because he heard something too. And
I have I say finally.
Right. You just hear.
He's really proud of us, guys.
Ring throughout the forest. Very
solid high five, man.
And everything is silent for a good 10 seconds.
Good.
Caca.
And then. I need the round one.
D100.
That's me.
A dust 100.
Hey.
Hey.
What happened?
A massive murder of crows comes flying out above your heads.
Wow, scary.
Just, exiting the forest above you.
Hold on, I want to catch one. Shit.
Catch a crow.
Catch its shit.
Oh, don't that'll touch be a, it. It'll be all oily.
That'll be a... Yeah. What's the one that make that with the fastness?
Crows?
Dexterity! I always want to call it agility.
You're 15.
You're so drunk you don't remember.
I don't know the words. What did you roll?
15.
15! Reacting with inhuman speed, because you indeed are not. You reach up and manage to grab one of the crows by the foot. And it is flipping its shit.
Okay.
Am I still on his back?
I pull out my skin and knife and go, all right, we get a pot of water going. We're going to have dinner.
Some crow oil stew.
No, I'm trying to make crow oil. I have a bucket. I put it in the bucket and I put the
Do you have a recipe?
Mess kit on top.
I smack his hand to let the crow go.
Roll for that.
Yeah, all right. Roll.
You guys roll against each other.
Okay.
4.
10.
Wow, nice rolls.
So you kind of gently tap his hand
like a child who's being bad.
No, let it go.
Stop it.
Let it go. Let it go. Don't want my crows to get oiled.
I guess Carl's just like hydraulic pressing the crow into the bottom of the bucket.
I put it in the bucket and I put the mess kit over it for later.
Okay, you're covering it. Okay, yeah, so there's just a crow in a bucket.
Yeah.
It is screeching. So this is screeching just, and.
So this is just—it's starting to look like a Sarah Palin interview. And...
I don't even get that, but it's still funny because you said Sarah Palin and she's silly. Yeah. And
she had an interview literally in front of a turkey slaughterhouse while turkeys were being fed into a turkey slaughter machine.
Fed into the turkey puree machine.
Seriously,
she was almost the second most powerful human being in the world.
I don't want to like.
I want to keep it to grease it for later, but I don't know. If it's making noises or anything.
It's making an unholy racket.
I have animal handling. Can I, like, calm it down?
You
want to
handle that animal?
Oh, yeah. Come on, Lenny. Don't do that.
I got a 6.
Okay.
It's making a lot of noise. You poke a little hand in there and try to, I don't know what you're doing.
Like inside the crow?
You get your finger repeatedly bit by a crow, but you're made of metal, so it doesn't really affect you.
Right. It hurts a little bit.
All right, Carl, let me put my hand in there now.
No, a little bit scratched up.
No, I pushed them away. I said, let me calm it.
I got a
nat
20 on my animal handling.
Did you really?
What? Yeah. I got... That's the third nat 20 in a row, by the way.
God damn, dude.
Just fuck you.
Hey, Mark, can you push that candle back from the ledge a little bit?
Why do you like to live dangerously?
I wish you could push that candle off the ledge, my friend. Get wax all over your carpet, hey, please.
I don't put my hand in there. I open the lid up and just make little crow noise. It just...
What kind of crow noise is that?
I'm a crow. I think those were Tim Crowlin grunts.
God damn this episode.
For those who are still listening.
And then I open the lid up and let it go.
Why?
You open the lid, it flaps up and lands on your shoulder.
Oh shit, Alan's gonna get jealous.
Tim Allen.
Tim Allen Jackson. Okay. I love that we always laugh at that thing that the listeners will never hear.
They can't hear it.
There are multiple episodes where I quote snake people in familiar songs.
Just randomly. Yeah. Oh, God, what was that sound?
So it's my crow buddy now?
It likes you.
Is it tiny? Is it my micro buddy?
No, it's a regular size crow. It's not a raven, so it's not huge, but it's kind of like a grackle.
Cool, I got a crow buddy now.
I take it off his shoulder and put it back in the bucket.
it freaks out at your touch.
Gosh, dude, just let it hang out on me. You can grease it.
And it kind of hides behind Jedwin.
Sorry. There you go.
So is the oil from the crow leaking on you as you're coughing oil back onto the crow?
It sits up on Jedwin's shoulder and chastises you in crow language. Just,
you know what's so... You know what's so much bullshit? Because I'm the druid that has... Like super
You were about to reach in there, and Jedwin jumped down at it and started whispering.
I could have had a crow friend.
You could have a crowversation with it.
Oh.
Oh, hey man, you could have just talked to this using magic. But I got my crow cooing just.
He loves it. It's cool. It's fine.
He's like, hey crow. Oh,
yeah.
Ow.
I continue walking away from all of this situation.
I'm going to name him John Crozak.
Crover Cleveland.
I'm just drunk enough to find that hilarious.
You were going
to
say Russell Crowe?
No.
No, it's too obvious.
What? No.
Yeah, Corey, what the fuck, man?
Now, if you said Crover Cleveland.
See, I just rolled a nat 1, so I leave. I just leave the entire party. I'm just gone.
Okay. We have an opening for a new druid. If anybody wants to,
technically, I'm taming animals, so I can be the warlock.
Yeah,
and
I mean,
the druid.
Shit, that's all druids really do. They're not good for anything else.
Did Damn, I still love you, Corey. Corey, come back.
Come back, Corey.
He turned his mic off. He's done.
Good night, Corey.
Good night, Corey.
Sleep tight in Matt's bed. I'll be in there later.
Okay, we got to get somewhere. So,
going
yeah.
somewhere
he
with
just,
Mark.
He watches all
it's
of
a
this.
Fun journey.
Just kind of with just a little bit. You notice, you see a look on his face? It kind of reminds you of his son. Because he's looking at you just with a little bit of awe and bewilderment. Just
so I kind of get an inkling to pick him up and forcibly make him
move
something.
Like that's dumb we probably all not are. A good idea because he's actually a pretty tall, rugged looking guy.
I consider it,
he has,
but I don't do
he
it.
He has a beard.
Okay.
Oh.
I respect him more because of his beard. I also
he has an
have
elf
beard.
Beard.
All right, guys. I'm going to try to introduce Alan to John Krozak to see how this goes.
Just stick them in a sack together and whichever one
shake
comes
it up.
Out, shake it up.
Shake that sack till they make friends.
I love playing sack ball. So he goes, all right, well, you certainly are a... Oh, God, I forgot. I turned him into Erdrin.
Yeah, you really did.
You guys certainly are a talented group.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that might come in handy someday.
Probably not, but sure.
Shall we continue?
Yes, please.
I'd like to think that the like stupid decisions our party makes is because our party is also drinking while we're drinking
of
as
course.
We're playing.
Yeah,
Fumbles
they're just
drink.
Constantly passing bottles of booze around.
We never mentioned it, but the entire party is our problem
we're just
drinkers.
Me and my sherry.
This one's a vintage.
It's just all cooking sherry that Lena doesn't cook with it.
Well, I don't cook much anymore. Other than my insides.
Okay,
so,
let's go somewhere.
You guys eventually make it to what looks to be a bit of a clearing. And you look ahead, you see what look like several, you see thatched huts. You see what look to be lookouts and tree towers. Mm. It's all kind of built into the forest. It's kind of a clearing, but it's very...
It's an elven city.
Sort of. Ooh. Other than... If you remember the lore, the descendants are actually all human.
It's a elven human descendant city.
You know, one of those.
It's very dick.
So these are like the half breeds that the king wants us
all perception
to
rolls.
Do genocide on.
17.
9.
Come on, baby. Don't give me another one. Shit, where am I? D20.
3. That's better.
Plus,
man, if only you were a halfling.
Plus one.
I lost my d20.
Reroll
guys.
Those ones.
Help.
It's down on the ground help. Right here.
Damn it. Matt stole it.
I have a lot of,
no,
I
wait,
a lot
no,
of dice that I dropped, so.
Wait.
I got 18.
What the fuck? All my dice are on the ground.
Those are all mine.
Why did Mark's dice give me
his
dice on the ground?
Damn it.
Thank you, sir.
I don't know where my d20 went still.
Okay. Did everybody
win? Oh, wait. I have Matt.
I got an 18.
Okay.
So, oh, fuck nat 20. Goddamn shit.
All three of you guys...
we see notice, real good, y'all.
You notice a bit of rustling around you, and you look to the sides and realize that there are human forms creeping up.
I say, hello. Hello.
Hello.
You greet each one of the shadows you see.
At your mention, you see... several of the forms pull what looks like arrows from their back.
Oh, shit.
And kind of hold,
that
the,
must have hurt.
Hold the bows up.
Do you hear that classic movie, like, drawing of the bow? Just like the creaking wood.
Like leather moving a little bit.
Yeah.
And it turns into one of those movie scenes where, like, somebody, like, holds a drawn bow to somebody's head like it's a gun.
Yeah, for like
and it's
4
like,
minutes.
Yeah, let's see how long you can hold that 100 pounds of weight.
You tell us the information, please, or you're gonna die anyways.
Shit!
Before they get too close, I use my telepathy to put the information of where we are
yes, oh, wait, go on.
Into John Krozak and tell him to go back to the king with it.
Oh, shit. Oh, yeah.
Okay. I was gonna increase him. When we finally settled down,
you see the crow take off, and one of the figures pulls
you,
back
Steven.
To shoot an arrow towards it. Dravik, what am I smelling?
What?
I just smelled something terrible.
I just burped.
It's probably Jesus.
Good God.
That was my vomit
what
burp.
What in the last month?
No, that was my, I have acid reflux vomit sitting in my throat at
wanna,
all times.
You want to eat an entire box of Prilosec, like with the box and foil?
I should. I just belched and blew it towards Mark.
Just a pile of charcoal.
Sorry,
that
I don't
might
recover
help.
For that one.
Sorry.
Dravik steps forward, says, hold his hand up.
Go ahead.
I scared my damn crow off.
And all of the bows lower.
Oh, that goes.
You talking to animals now, too?
To my animals.
Should I just walk away?
All the bows lower, and four men in kind of a raggedy, like, forest-looking attire, like leather.
Hi, raggedy ragamuffins.
Step out and take a knee, and Dravik turns towards you. Gentlemen? Welcome
Let
to the Descendants. God, fuck up everything I say.
I didn't even hear what she said.
What'd you say? This is where joy is?
No, I said lend me your ears because he said take a knee. And I was thinking of Robin Hood Men in Tights where he said lend me your ears and they all pulled their ears off and threw them at him. I think they could all take a knee off and throw it at us.
Okay, so this is
the
where...
The end of the episode.
Well, he's mad, I'm sorry.
Well, that made me think of Aerosmith, Welcome to the Jungle. So I had...
Aerosmith?
Knees, knees.
That's not Aerosmith.
I mean, Guns and fucking Roses.
Arrows and Roses.
Same fucking shit. It's all shitty music anyway.
Guns and Arrows.
Guns and Aerosmiths. Fuck you. God damn it, I'm drunk.
That was Party Roll. We'll see you next time.